This is for my slam team. At my last trip to Women of the World Poetry Slam in 2011, I remember sitting in a workshop led by Rachel McKibbins where she stated, and I quote, "You are your poem's instrument." Fast forward to National Poetry Slam 2012, after Team Snow, affectionately known as Team Snow Slam New Orleans, is crowned champions. We left everything we had left on stage in the form of two group pieces and two individual poems. We returned home feeling like the Saints after the Super Bowl in 2010 to a city that had lost everything in 2005 and desperately needed to know what it felt like to win again. But in addition to a sparkling title and a shiny new trophy, we also went home with the glaring criticism of our peers. Other poets who thought our voices more quartet than quill pen. Other poets who couldn't appreciate the melody in our metaphors. Other poets who didn't know that we met about four survivors who confessed to us after our bout that their souls sang along with the words to "Mama ain't seen." Because sometimes restless things like broken records of broken families and sexual abuse require a poem in the form of a lullaby. So today I stand on this stage to tell you we will not apologize for the songs in our hearts that sometimes spill over the broken levees of our mouths. See, maybe now everyone else will feel what it's like to drown or to have every single notebook you've ever owned submerged in murky water until you can no longer read the words and say what you want about our ministry. But we know that just like us, so many people need to be saved. So we can't help it if from time to time a gospel choir stands in for our slam team. If we sound more Mahalia than Anis Mojgani, it is because we cannot shake the dust or the residue of mold that has formed over our vocal cords. See, Katrina taught us what it feels like to have all of your instruments swallowed whole. So now we protect them by hiding them in our very own throat. So sometimes when we spit, we choke and we cough up music notes. See, there is an old Baptist tradition where after someone is baptized and they rise up from the water, everyone rejoices for the new person who has emerged and they lift up their voices in a hymn because sometimes words and poems are not enough when you have survived a raging storm. So we will not apologize if sometimes our poems sound a lot like the hymns Mama Dear used to sing after a baptism, like, "Toll the bell, done got over, toll the bell, done got over, toll the bell, done got over at last."